All right, today on Repairs 101, I'm going to address a request from a viewer that I got back in January. And, well, it's June right now, so I got to say, I'm really sorry it took me this long to get to it. All right, well, today on Repairs 101, we're at the shipyard. And we're going to talk about air compressors and pneumatic tools. There is a serious compressor. So here's a beautiful air compressor setup. That one's just permanently mounted in the back of this service truck.
You can see that it says 30 gallons.
So there's an engine mounted air compressor, direct driven on the side of this fairly new Cummins diesel. Here's a good sized tank on the back of this service truck. All right, now speaking of air compressors, here's a couple of tow behind air compressors made by the Solair company. This bigger one over here delivers 125 pounds of pressure and 425 cubic feet per minute, which is quite an impressive amount of air. You use that for sandblasting equipment or jackhammers, that kind of air operated equipment. When you go to choose an air compressor, what's funny is that the first thing you'll see listed about it is the tank size, which in reality is about the least important thing to do with the air compressor. What's really important is the pump size and the motor size, and the pump will be, it'll be rated in cubic feet per minute. If you can't find the rating for how many cubic feet per minute the air pump is going to make, then it's safe to say that you're going to get 3 or 4 cubic feet per minute for every horsepower. A lot of hobbyist machines, their rated horsepower has been exaggerated by marketing departments in order to sell more. If it's a 110 plug-in, then it's not going to be more than 2 horsepower. Otherwise, it'll have a 220 volt hookup. You know, the pressure rating on it, again, is not that important. They should all make at least 90 to 110 PSI. Now, if you need higher pressure than 90 to 110, you're going to have to look at a two-stage air compressor. When you have a two-stage air compressor, you might have as much as 175 PSI. So the duty cycle of your air compressor is one of the more important things that you can try and find out. The duty cycle is how long it's rated to keep running during use. So if you have a hobbyist air compressor that's duty cycle is 50%, that means 50% of the time you're using it, the motor can be running safely and without overheating. If you exceed 50% of the time, then you're in danger of wearing out your pump a lot faster than you had bargained for. Commercial duty air compressors, on the other hand, have duty cycles of 75% and even 100%. You don't even need a tank if you got an air compressor with 100% duty cycle. So if you're a hobbyist, you know, 50% duty cycle is probably all you need, but if you're running a shop and you've got a lot of guys, perhaps you're going to want to look at something industrial with a 75 or even 100% duty cycle. 5 horsepower compressor with 100% duty cycle is going to make more air than a 7.5 horsepower compressor that only has a 75% duty cycle. If it is for commercial use, you really should get as big a compressor as you can afford, because you won't be sorry. So to choose the right compressor, you're going to have to ask yourself what kind of demands you're going to be making. What are the air tools that you're going to be using? What applications are you going to be using them for? Are they going to be more than one user at a time? Is it going to be intermittent use, or is it going to be continuous duty?
Go look at my file folder of owner's manuals and technical data. Okay, this is for
3 cubic feet per minute, then, just to operate this little right angle grinder. And a right angle drill this time, again, 6 cubic feet per minute. Little cutoff saw, 4 cubic feet per minute for this. This one's an air body saw. It's basically a pneumatic hacksaw. Great for doing body work. 6 cubic feet per minute for this one. All right, so this is an air hammer. It's rated at, again, 90 psi, of course, and 4.4 cubic feet per minute. This pistol grip drill consumes 4 cubic feet per minute, again, rated at 90 psi. 3/8 impact gun, that's rated at 4 cubic feet per minute. Another style 3/8 pneumatic wrench, again, rated at 4 cubic feet per minute. And 4 cubic feet per minute for this one as well. As far as my personal impact tools go, this is my heavy hitter, and again, it only uses 4 cubic feet per minute. 1-inch impact gun. Need a real good air supply to drive something like that. Okay, so now just a couple of drops of motor oil in the end of your tools. It might be 10W30 or 1540 or 530, you know, whatever it's around, straight 3008 oil. Now I picked this little beauty up for $20.
1 gallon tank with a little tiny compressor on the back. Perfect for, inflating bicycle tires or doing cleaning around the shop, that kind of work. You can't really power any tools with something like this. For the money I paid for it, I don't expect very much out of it.
You can see I put a quick connect fitting on the end. Quick connect like that. And connect it. There, now it's already part of the system. Just pull back like that. Snap it on. Pull back and it comes off. So here's examples of 3 different fitting ends. Anyway, there are all kinds of different fitting ends that you might pick to go with your quick connector, and I would recommend you just look at the place where you work or what fittings came with the equipment you bought and just go with that. So don't forget to wear your safety glasses, and please remember what I always say about power tools, which is use both hands and both eyes.